Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. And in this video, I am going to update an old tutorial. And the tutorial that I am talking about is the Android login and signup tutorial using the MVVM architecture. So in that course, we learned everything from creating backend APIs to following MVVM architecture, and we created a complete authentication system for our Android application, and we also used OAuth 2. But few things I missed on that course. The first and the major thing was the dependency injection. And we have this new library now that is called Hilt for dependency injection. So what I did is I updated the repository, or basically the code of that tutorial, and I have created a new branch and I have pushed the updated code that is using the dependency injection in the same project. And for the dependency injection, I am using Hilt for this project. So if you want to know how you can follow dependency injection in the same project, then you can get the updated code from the repository. And I have updated few more things, like I have changed how we create fragment, how we use view binding, and I have also added the authenticator of retrofit. So if you want to know how you can use authenticator or refresh token, then you can know how you can use it in your Android project with the help of this new updated code. And I have also updated the backend API. So all the previous course link you can find in the description of this video, or you can click on this link to get to the previous course. So I have updated everything, and now this application is perfect, I think. And you can use this authentication for your production level application. In case you think there is a flaw or something wrong with the project, then please let me know by commenting below. Now, the important point of publishing this video is, right now I will tell you that how you can download the code and how you can switch the branch and how you can explore the updated code. And in this video, I am not going to teach you Hilt because I will create a separate tutorial for this topic. In this video, I am just telling you that I have updated the code with Hilt, and you can download the code and you can study on your own. And in case you have any question or confusion, you can leave your comments below and I will try to help you out for sure. So please get the code and study how you can use Hilt by reviewing my code, and you can also follow the official documentation of Hilt. I will leave the link in the description of this video. So for now, let's see how you can download my code and how you can switch to the branch that has the updated code. So this is the code repository, that is Android login and signup tutorial. You just need to click here and copy this link. Now go to Android Studio and select this option, that is get from version control. Now paste your link here, and this is the directory where the code will be downloaded. So it is, let's say, login sample, or you can name your directory anything, and I will clone the project. So once the project is loaded, what you can do is you can right click and go to get, and from here you can select branches, and you need to select this branch that is called dependency injection. So I will check out this branch. Now we are inside the dependency injection branch, and this branch has the updated code. That means I am using dependency injection here that I have not covered in the last course. So I will show you that I have created a new package, that is DI. And here we have our app module, and here we have everything. So it's giving us some error. So what we need to do is we need to rebuild the project. So now Gradle build is done and we don't have any error, as you can see here, and we can run the application now. So I will show you by running the application. It is basically the same thing. We are just using dependency injection now, and I am also using one more thing that is called authenticator. So we have this token authenticator here as well. So these two are the major things that I have updated in this project There are many other changes as well that you can check out by cloning the repository. So let's run the application now. So this is our application and it is working absolutely fine. So what I can do is I can log in. I will show you by login in like this. Let's hit login and we are inside the application and we will see the information. So this is working absolutely fine. So now your task is to get the code, study the code, and if you have any question or confusion, just leave it in the comments below and we will have a great discussion and we will sort out each other queries. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. And in case you have any request or any feedback, please leave that in the comment section below. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.